The flower's dying. It needs water. I cannot enter.
Good evening, Mr. Cox.
Dr. Reed.
Still working at night, I see. I like that.
And why is that?
People who don't sleep at night always seem more alive to me. More interesting, one way or another.
Do you ever think about that poor fellow I saw you push in the water?
The wound he gave me will make sure I don't forget him. Still fucking hurts. Boss, it cut me good.
That man was determined to murder you. You almost died.
What a surprise. The first time I met him, he nearly shit himself. Fucking coward. Oh, I guess revenge gives you balls.
What did he want? Revenge?
I recently had to kill his brother. Poor arsehole thought it would be easy to return the favor.
Perhaps you're right. Maybe only the strongest will survive in these dark times.
If there must be only one, in the end, make no mistake, I'll be the winner.
How is your hospitalization going, Mr. Cox?
This is a shitty place with shitty staff. But as long as I'm treated all right, I'll be fine.
What's wrong with the Pembroke staff?
That bastard you sent to bring me here, Milton. I thought he was going to break all my bones before I reached my bed.
I see. Any other smart comments?
The nurses aren't too ugly. Especially that foxy one, Nurse Crane. Pretty brunette, tough attitude, all like that.
What's wrong with the hospital?
Come on, Dr. Reed. The place is a dump. Smelly, sad, and dirty.
But you're alive thanks to the efforts and dedication of the staff here, aren't you?
What are you expecting, a medal? I thought that saving lives was just part of the job. Must be an unsatisfactory profession at this time, I'm sure.
To assume your wife's letter pissed you off, Clay.
I was so mad I threw away the knife she got me when we got married.
Your wife gave you a knife as a wedding present.
That knife has always been my lucky charm. If I'd had it in my hand when I got stabbed on that pier, I'd not have been wounded.
Do you want it back?
I don't need it here, but if you'd be kind enough to bring it to me, I'd be really grateful.
A grateful Clay Cox? I might just find your knife and bring it back to you to see that happen.
I can give you directions, but I'd be surprised if you managed to find it. My hideout isn't meant to be found easily.
A lucky charm. I never would have taken you as the superstitious type.
We all have our flaws, Doc. Mine's to have my weapon of choice for when the really dirty business comes around.
Can you tell me about your marriage, Clay?
Marriage is the sweetest cage, they say. Well, I found myself locked in one with a wild animal.
You mean your wife keeps you on your toes?
No, I mean we both have claws and we both love to bite.
How long do you think you can escape the law, Clay?
I know this city like the back of my hand, Doc. I know its streets, who to pay, who to avoid, and who to bully. I won't get caught.
We can't escape the consequences of our actions. The past catches up with us in the end.
I ain't afraid of death. I don't hide who I am. I live my life honestly, which is more than I could say for most folks.
And who are you, then?
I'm the leader of the Wet Boot Boys. One day, I'll leave this shitty place and punch in the face all who thought I would not come back.
I'll leave you for now, Mr. Cox.
Ain't safe here for a gentleman. God's mine!
Best for your foam.
Stay away! See them fancy clothes? This one's a tough!
Thank you.
allies will arrive and then sadly depart.
It's locked, all right. William Bishop. Must be the same strain. This sickness moves faster than influenza. It's locked. Surely grant me access to the basement. It's locked, all right. It's locked. walls of Mars. Fortifiers. As popular as they are ineffective. But they do contain iron tartrate, and that might prove itself useful.